G'day. In this video we're making 800 steel ferrules. Here's the simulation of the part. Drill the hole first. Then we use a boring bar to complete the counterbore. These ferrules are actually crimped onto a automotive cable. The material we'll be using is S1214, which is a free cutting steel. You can see here I've got the parting tool going way in, which means that the parts actually get dropped off. They get dropped off because they're fairly light, they don't bounce around and do too much damage to themselves, so I don't have to knock them off after parting. As any time I use steel, this is the sort of mess I end up with. You get swarf that just takes up so much volume in a bag compared with the small chips that I get from aluminium or brass. It's really difficult. You end up having to store a huge number of bags before you get rid of them to the recycler, and of course you get nothing at the recycle place. Here we're drilling 9.1. That feed is about half the normal feed, simply because the lathe didn't have the power to drive the drill in at the correct feed. You'll see a shot in a moment of the ammeter and you'll see it's drawing 5 amps, which is the rating for the motor. And you can see the collet holder there. It's just much easier using that when there's lots of parts to make. Finish drilling the hole. Bring up a boring bar. It's mounted in the turret for this job. Had a comment about the G and the M letters in the letter code, and it was suggested that G is for ground and M is for molded, and I looked it up and actually those letters refer to the tolerance, but G is much tighter than M, so it's possibly the way to achieve that tighter tolerance is to grind the insert. So although it's not correct, it's quite possible that that's the way it is. A ground insert with a tighter tolerance will have a G letter, whereas an M for a much wider tolerance can be achieved with a molded insert. There, the thing's parted off. Now this is because in this lathe there's no collet closer and there's no long nose for the collet holder. So a 600 long bar sticks out a lot further in this lathe than it does in the other one. As you can see here, the collet closer itself takes up a fair amount of length, and so does the nose at the other end. But on this one I'm using a chuck, and we're having to use a different drill setup, because if the other lathe couldn't handle a 9mm drill at the proper feed, this one was not going to go anywhere near it. So I'm using a 6mm stub drill to open the hole up so that when the 9.1 goes through, it won't nearly be as difficult. So that's the 6mm hole drilled. And we'll change over to the 9.1. Feed there is a lot faster than in the other one, but it's got a heck of a lot less metal to remove, and by using short pecks I limited the swarf length. Don't like turning steel. Poses a lot of problems, quite apart from being hard work for the machines compared with brass and aluminium. It's just the handling of the swarf. It's not much fun at all. the boring bar finishing. That's an FC insert, which is virtually a general purpose insert for me. I'll use it on brass, steel, aluminium. It lasts quite well on steel. It's a ground insert, but it's made for doing finishing cuts in steel. And there's another one done. Towards getting the 800 finished. Now here's a look at the parts. One on the left is as it came off the lathe. These parts had to be barrel zinc plated, where they are put into a barrel and rotated in the plating tank. There's the difference. Thank you for watching.